الحمد لله، الحمد لله المبدئ المعيد، الغني الحميد، ذي العفو الواسع والعقاب الشديد. من هداه فهو السعيد السديد، ومن أضله فهو الطريد البعيد، ومن أرشده إلى سبل النجاة ووفقه فهو الرشيد. يعلم ما ظهر وما بطن، وما خفي وما علن، وما هجن وما حسن، وهو أقرب إلى الكل من حبل الوريد. قسم الخلق قسمين وجعل لهم منزلتين، فريق في الجنة وفريق في السعير، إن ربك فعال لما يريد. أحمده سبحانه وهو أهل الحمد والتحميد، وأشكره جل جلاله، والشكر لديه من أسباب المزيد. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، بهرت عظمته عقول العارفين، وظهرت أنواره لبصائر السالكين، وظهرت بدائعه لنواظر المتأملين. وأشهد أن محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله، وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح للأمة، فكشف الله به الغمة، وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها، لا يزيغ عنها إلا كل هالك، ولا يتبعها إلا كل منيب سالك. اللهم صل وسلم وزد وبارك على نبينا وحبيبنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد، dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah سبحانه وتعالى grants the Muslimin now and then opportunities for the forgiveness and acceptance. And Allah سبحانه وتعالى from season to another season of worship tells us as Muslims how to take advantage of these seasons to get the most of it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows better about His servants. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what benefits us and what harms us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows how weak sometimes we get because of the influence of shaitan upon us. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, that's me, I know you, and I'm gonna grant you opportunities of ta'a so you can fix what you messed up, so you can get better, you can get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, better and better. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in days like these days that we have right now, ordered the Muslimin and his servants to go and perform Fariidatul Hajj, one of the most important and significant fara'id that we perform as Muslims. وهو ركن الإسلام الأعظم كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Muslimin go from everywhere aiming at Mecca to perform al-Hajj for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, gathering themselves from everywhere, collecting their money from the halal purposes only, seeking Allah's pleasure subhanahu wa ta'ala, and seeking to perform the most important rukn in al-Islam, which is al-Hajj. In days like these days, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give the Muslimin the opportunity, even those who do not go to al-Hajj, to have the same opportunity like those who go to get the most of the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as well. So as a Muslim staying here, I'm not capable of going to Mecca to perform al-Hajj. I still have opportunity from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to get the reward from Him. These days, the first 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran the qualities and the importance, the virtue of these days to tell us this is something important to take. This is something you cannot miss as a Muslim. This opportunity, that's for every Muslim to take advantage of. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to tell us that Allah swore in the Quran by those days in the Quran. فقال والفجر وليال عشر. قال عبد الله بن عباس رضي الله تعالى عنهما وليال عشر, the first 10 days of ذو الحجة. والله سبحانه وتعالى does not swear except with something great, because the greater سبحانه وتعالى, the greatest سبحانه وتعالى swears only by great things. These days are important to us because Allah سبحانه وتعالى mentioned and counted these days in different categories in the Quran to tell us this is something important you have to pay attention to. فالله سبحانه وتعالى في القرآن قال والفجر وليال عشر. In a different
position in the Quran. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى والسماء ذات البروج واليوم الموعود وشاهد ومشهود. The scholar said مشهود, the witness day is the day of Arafah, which is one of the days of the first 10 days of Al-Hijjah, of the Hijjah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also told us that the days that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke with Musa alayhi salam, حينما تجلى الله سبحانه وتعالى لموسى عليه السلام, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to Musa alayhi salam on the Jabal, the mountain of At-Tur in Sinai in Egypt, for 40 days. كما قال ربنا في سورة الأعراف ووعدنا موسى 30 ليلة, for 30 nights. وأتممناها بعشر, and we completed them with another 10. قال عبد الله بن عباس the first 30 nights that was شهر ذو القعدة, and the other 10 nights that was the first 10 days of شهر ذو الحجة. In these days also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala included all of the ibadat, the arkan in al-Islam in these 10 days. So in these 10 days we have kalimatu tawheed. Since every Muslim goes to al-Hajj making talbiyah and performing at-talbiyah, labbaik Allahumma labbaik, labbaik la sharika laka labbaik. And at-talbiyah means at-tawheed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the only true God and not God, no God but Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we pray, we can fast these 10 days, and also for those who can give the zakah in those 10 days, they can give the zakah, which is another fard in al-Islam. Then above that, we perform al-hajj, faridatul hajj, and we cannot perform al-hajj except in those 10 days, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala obligated upon us. So all of the arkan of al-Islam collectively came to be performed in these 10 days, subhanallah al-azim. That's why they are important to us as Muslims. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also told us that there is one day in these 10 days, one of the best days at the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is Yawm Arafah. Yawm Arafah, when the Hujjaj go onto the mountain to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, look at them, forgive all of their sins and free them from his fire. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even beyond that, yubahi bihim al-malaika. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala boast about them to the angels. Unzuru ila ibadi, ja'uni min kulli fajjin amiq, yarjuna rahmati wa yakhafuna azabi. Ushidukum anni qad ghafartu lahum. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all of them. Dear brothers and sisters, the first 10 days of Shahru Dhul Hijjah, they come every year, not every month. And as a Muslim, as a smart Muslim, if I don't take advantage of these 10 days, that means I'm missing a lot with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm missing the forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm missing that to be set free from the fire from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-itq min al-niran. I am missing to be among those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala look at them and boast about them to the angels. يُبَاهِ بِهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ. And even if that only for the hujjaj over there, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can include you among them if you try to do your best during these 10 days. So when we talk about these 10 days, we talk about يوم النحر, يوم العيد, the best day ever that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted the Muslimin. أعظم الأيام عند الله يوم النحر, كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. So what do we do? Are we going to miss this chance? 10 days. If you are working in a company and your boss in the company telling you, I have an opportunity of investment for you in the company, and I'm going to give you this profit, that's something you cannot imagine, beyond what you can imagine. But just I need from you 10 days to work hard on a task. Are you going to miss this chance? Are you going to try to say, I don't care? Of course not. You will do your best. You're going to stay up day and night trying to work on that to get the profit, to get the reward, and to make you successful. Why when it comes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and our business, our investment with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we take it easy as something, I will do it later on. No, brothers. Wallahi, al-aqil, the smart one, who will take the opportunity as if it's last opportunity for me in this life. As if I will die after that. So I want to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the most reward I can make. So how can I perform during these 10 days of Dhul Hijjah? Number one, brothers, you have to start clean with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have to purify yourself and your heart before you start to do any kind of act of worship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At-tawbah with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we say at-tawbah with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, most Muslims take it easy. Like, what do you mean? I mean, you have to regret all of the sins you have committed with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And trying to promise Him that you will never do that again. And you start with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from there as a new and a fresh start with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. By the way, when I tell you that, I'm not telling you have to do that because you're sinful. Even the mu'mineen, even the believers, they need to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قال الله وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. So you might be successful. أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. التَّوْبَ النَّصُوحِ. وَاللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى expands his hands to you every day and night, asking you, oh, you who committed sins in the morning, I'm expanding my hands to you. Are you going to come to me or not? We cannot neglect Allah's appeal to us. We cannot ignore these brothers and Muslims and sisters in Islam. At-tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So now I'm clean, I'm pure with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I'm ready to start. What is the second thing I can do with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The second thing I can do with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to work on my intention, to have a truthful and sincere intention. Because you know what? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can give you the reward on the intention over the work you do. I cannot forget when the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was going for the battlefield, Ghazwat Tabuk, and he prepared the army as much as he could, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. A group of the Muslimin, poor people, they cannot afford it. They cannot buy a camel or horse to be carried on to go with him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they went to Nabi sallam, Ya Rasulallah, what should we do? فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لا أجد ما أحملكم علي. I can't find anything to carry you on to come with me. I can't. I have nothing. صلى الله عليه وسلم لا أجد ما أحملكم علي. What did they say? What did they do? They said Alhamdulillah, it comes from him. We have nothing to worry about. Alhamdulillah, we're gonna be safe. We stay home with our families. We're secure. They didn't say that. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described their status when he said تولوا وأعينهم تفيض من الدمع حزنا ألا يجدوا ما ينفقون. They turned back while they were tearing. Why? They were sad that they couldn't find what they spent to go with the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Do we tear? Do we have tears when we miss a chance with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to do a good ibadah? To take advantage of the season of the worship and the ta'ah with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The truthful intention. Wallah, when Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam قال إنما الأعمال بالنيات. Make the intention, even though if you're not gonna fast, even though if you're gonna have shortcomings and fall short in some ibadat, make the intention. So if you die, you get the reward and you die on this, in this intention with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Dear brothers, now alhamdulillah, I repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I purified my heart. Now I have the sincere intention with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is the third thing I can do? The third thing I can do to know the virtue of these days. How can you take advantage of these days while you do not know anything about them? You know nothing about Yawm Arafah. You know nothing about the fasting on these days. You know nothing about Yawm Nahr. You know nothing about the reward of sacrificing of Al-Udhiyah. You know nothing. So how are you gonna take that usefully and to take advantage of that? You will not. So we need to learn and educate ourselves about these days and explain that to our kids and learn and learn. Brothers, for how long we're gonna live ignorant about our deen till we die? For how long we're gonna stay ignorant and know nothing about the most important things in our deen? Some Muslims, they are 50 and 60 and 70 years old and they know just only the basics about their religion. Is it worthy to spend some time to invest your time in learning your deen? Wallahi, one day I made a test for my brothers, my beloved brothers in the masjid, asking them about the meaning of the surahs, the names of the surahs, the short surahs in the Quran. And that was a surprise to me. Just only two or three amongst like 100 people, do you know the meaning of a samad or al kawthar or al adiyat or short surahs in the Quran? How are you going to function and worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while you do not know nothing about that? Brothers, this is wallahi a sincere advice from your brother in Islam. Number four, to take advantage of these days, you have to stick with some brothers that you know for sure they will help you and carry you on the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you miss a chance, they will remind you. If you forget, they will remind you. If you're not coming to the masjid, they will check upon you. They will call you. Where are you? You cannot be away from the masjid. These days, al-fajr, time comes early. So many people do not come to pray al-fajr. Na jama'a in al-masjid. Why? It's early. I'm sleeping. It's hard to wake up. Even in the first 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah, you can't do that, brother. You can't do that. You cannot miss that. At least do salawat al-jama'a in al-masjid. At least maintain your adhkar al-sabah and al-masa' morning and evening with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Discipline yourself for 10 days. And you know how time goes fast, subhanallah al-azim. We were talking about Ramadan just a couple of days ago. Now we're talking about شهر ذي الحجة and فريضة الحج, subhanallah al-azim. Dear brothers and sisters in al-Islam, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم told us that when we die, we will be questioned about four things. One of them, the first one, عن عمره فيما أفناه, about your life, how you spent your life. How did you spend your life? In what? Just passing days and times, missing all of the opportunities from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to all the time to remind his sahaba and his companions about the importance of the time. And this is the capital of the human being. If you miss that and you play around this, you will never get any chance to be successful with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As'al Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala أن يتقبل مني ومنكم صالح الأعمال. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه. الحمد لله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا وحبيبنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. Dear brothers and sisters, if we are here this year, we don't have opportunity to go to Al-Hajj, we have to talk to ourselves. We have to wish that if we had the ability to go, we would go, Ya Rab. We have this intention, we have the wish and the hope to go to perform Al-Hajj with Al-Hajij. Brothers, if you have the ability, especially financially, and you didn't perform Al-Hajj so far, you're committing a huge and a major sin. If you are capable of performing al-hajj and you just worry about the money, that's a big and huge sin that you're committing with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every year it's getting expensive, more and more. So if you have the money right now, make the intention and the promise with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the plan for it and have a strategy and just go and do not worry. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you more and more and bless the money for you and your family. Brothers, during these days, we will have the day of Arafah coming, inshallah, the 9th of Dhul-Hijjah. Yawm Arafah, كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. العمل ليس من عمل أحب إلى الله سبحانه وتعالى من عمل يوم عرفة. وإن الله سبحانه وتعالى لا يدنو ويباهي بعباده الملائكة ويقول لهم ماذا يريد هؤلاء. أو كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. That Allah سبحانه وتعالى bless the deeds of Yawm Arafah and come closer to subhanahu wa ta'ala and to boast about the people of the Hujjaj to his angels, and he asks them, what do they want? What do my servant want from me? So all, of course, they want the forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They want the acceptance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They want from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept all of the deeds they perform. Yawm Arafah, at least if you cannot fast during the 10 days, the 9 days, do not miss يوم عرفة to fast. As the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, يكفر سنتين, سنة ماضية وسنة قادمة, أو سنة مقبلة. The day of Arafah, fasting that day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive the sins of 2 years, the previous ones and the coming one. These days, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us in the hadith, ما من أيام العمل الصالح فيها أحب إلى الله من هذه العشر. There is no days that the good deeds are beloved to Allah سبحانه وتعالى more than these days, the 10 days of ذو الحجة. قال الصحابة: ولا الجهاد في سبيل الله يا رسول الله. Even though someone goes for الجهاد في سبيل الله, sacrificing his soul and his wealth and his family and his everything, قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: ولا الجهاد في سبيل الله. Even الجهاد في سبيل الله, except رجل خرج بنفسه وماله ولم يرجع من ذلك بشيء. Just a man left everything behind and he went to al-jihad and sacrificed his soul, himself and his wealth, and he never came back with nothing. He never came back with anything. This is the only condition to be better than the good deeds in these days. So now, what is the promise we're going to have with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What is that covenant that we will hold in ourselves with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? I will tell Allah, Ya Rabb, I will never miss this chance. From today, alhamdulillah, we're fasting. Alhamdulillah, we're going to start maybe one khatm of Al-Quran, subhanAllah, in these 10 days. At least, Salat al-Jama'a fi al-Masjid 5 times. Adhkar al-Sabah wal-Masa'a, do not forget this. If you cannot discipline yourself and get to the routine to do that, at least in these 10 days. And when it comes to Yawm Arafah, brothers, free yourself. Stay in the Masjid. Be a good worshiper to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Make the same dua as Al-Hujjaj doing over there. If you can, try to watch the khutbat Yawm Arafah on the TV, watch it. And make ameen with the dua that the imam is doing. Try to feel the same feelings and to get the same emotions that they have over there. That's how can you live the same things that they are living over there, to feel that I'm with them, I'm not abandoned, I'm not alone. Finally, the Yawm al-Nahr, Yawm al-Eid, when we start to sacrifice al-Udhiyah. And here in the masjid, we accepted the Udhiyah from everyone and we feed all of the poor and needy people in the United States here, especially in our state. So if anyone who is interested to participate and to sacrifice this year, inshallah, we accept for $300 per person for the Udhiyah. And he can go to the office, inshallah, and arrange that with Brother Samir, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. So from today, we can start to plan for the Udhiyah. And with the first drop of the blood for the Udhiyah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives all of your sins. As the Nabi ﷺ mentioned in the hadith, and as he told Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha, can you imagine? All of the sins will be forgiven just by the first drop will fall on the ground from the Udhiyah. And as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, وَإِنَّهَا لَتَقَعُ بِمَكَانٍ مَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ قَبْلَ أَنْ تَقَعَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ فَطِيبُ بِهَا نَفْسًا. Before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept your Udhiyah before it falls on the ground. And be content with it, as the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned. We start to do takbir from today, at takbir al-muqayyad, just by yourself individually. You can start to say, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd. You can start to say that from now. And the takbir together after the salawat, inshallah, after the fajr of yawm arafah, bi-iznillahi rabbil alameen. Blessed days, opportunities from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for whoever is seeking forgiveness from him and acceptance. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى ألا يحرمني وإياكم من المغفرة والعتق من النيران في هذه الأيام. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت اللهم على الحق أقدامنا وانصرنا يا ربنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم يا ربنا ارزقنا حج بيتك الحرام وزيارة بيت حبيبك خير الأنام. اللهم يا ربنا إن لم يكن لنا نصيب في الحج في هذا العام فاجعل لنا نصيبا في العام القادم يا رب العالمين. اللهم كما جمعتنا في هذا المسجد سويا في هذه اللحظة المباركة اجمعنا في العام القادم على جبل عرفات يا رب العالمين، واجمعنا تحت ظل عرشك يوم لا ظل إلا ظله إخوانا متحابين. اللهم انصر الإسلام وأعز المسلمين. اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في كل مكان، في غزة ورفح وفي كل بقاع فلسطين وفي السودان وفي كل مكان يحارب فيه دين الإسلام. اللهم انصر دينك وسنة نبيك وعبادك الموحدين. اللهم آمين آمين. ومن أذن فليقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. الحج أشهر معلومات فمن فرض فيهن الحج فلا رفث ولا فسوق ولا جدال في الحج وما تفعلوا من خير يعلمه الله وتزودوا فإن خير الزاد التقوى واتقون يا أولي الألباب. ليس عليكم جناح أن تبتغوا فضلا من ربكم فإذا أفضتم من عرفات فاذكروا الله عند المشعر الحرام واذكروه كما هداكم وإن كنتم من قبله لمن الضالين. ثم أفيضوا من حيث أفاض الناس واستغفروا الله إن الله غفور رحيم.
الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. فإذا قضيتم مناسككم فاذكروا الله كذكركم آباءكم أو أشد ذكرا فمن الناس من يقول ربنا آتنا في الدنيا وما له في الآخرة من خلاق ومنهم من يقول ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار أولئك لهم نصيب مما كسبوا والله سريع الحساب.
الله أكبر.